named a 15-man test squad for India today.
We have.
First off, 15 rather than 16 men, presumably because it's a shorter test tour.
Yeah, it's a too much series, so really we couldn't justify taking 16 out there. We appreciate it's a subcontinent, but we think we're pretty well covered by what we've got.
On the batting side, Oeh Shah comes in as the extra batsman, if we can call it that, to give the depth there.
Yeah, he's merited that selection. He's played well this year, so he's merited his selection. Tough decision. There's one or two others knocking as well, but the selectors felt that he was the right man for that job, so he will cover for all eventualities.
And probably a good time to recap what was announced over the weekend, Michael Vaughan and the thinking there.
Well, the thinking with Michael is he's not been informed. He knows that, and we've had a long chat with him, and he's going to have a break and get himself mentally attuned again. We know what he's capable of. There's a lot of cricket coming up in the next year or so. He's centrally contracted because we hope he's going to be a vital part of our next year. So he's going to have his break, and then we'll work with him and work out which is the best way forward for him. And he'll be trying, I'm sure, to try to get into the West Indies squad, but we'll work on that and monitor it continually.
Now, there's two wicketkeepers named. Matt Prior comes back into the test squad alongside Tim Ambrose. What was the thinking there?
Well, we'll need two keepers, obviously. Again, we're subcontinent, so something can happen very much in the morning. And unfortunately, the wicketkeeper is a one-position situation, so we need cover in that area. We felt that was the right area to go. You know, Matt comes in and Tim's in there anyway, so it was a cover, but they were the two that the selectors went with.
At this stage, is there a first choice, second choice? Is there, you know, to see how it goes through
well,
the ODI series?
Well, they'll vie between each other, basically. You know, they've both got strengths that can come to the fore in that foreign country. But we'll have to wait and see what the conditions are like, and then giving the options to Kevin and Peter to make that decision on the day.
On the bowling side, the same pace attack, fairly straightforward, probably picked itself for you. But you've gone for Graham Swann as a second spinner. He's uncapped, but what was the thinking there?
Well, let's go on to the seamers to start with. Yes, they've bowled really well, obviously, last year, and it's created a new squad for us, a bowling squad, with Fred and Harmy coming into the situation. So that's good for us. So we've got a nice round squad there of five seamers who are quality international seamers. From a spin point of view, Graham's come in to give us those options. I've already got Monty in there, so Graham comes in to give us that variation if necessary. So if we need to play two spinners, you've got the left arm and the off spin as well.
But it's something, you know, we consider a twin spin attack against India.
Could do. You know, we have to wait and see what the conditions are like. Peter and Kevin will make that decision on the day.
And the venues themselves are made a bad Mumbai. What are they likely to throw up for England?
We don't know, really. We'll have to wait and see. They can throw up anything, you know, but we've just got to make sure we're covered, and I think we are fairly well covered, so whatever they turn up with for us, we'll have a good enough side to compete.
And a two-test series gives enough for both sides to really show their mettle and compete?
Yeah, I think so. It's ideal to have a 3, 4 or 5, obviously, but a 2, you know, we take each test match at a time and each session at a time, so yes, there's lots to play for, and it's not just about this series. We might like to win series, but it's moving on as well, so we'll find out about one or two of the players.
Yeah, as you say, it's a 2-test, which then gives a good preparation for a longer tour in the Caribbean ahead of a big summer in 09.
Well, we don't want to look too far ahead. You know, we've got to make sure that we create the momentum in the series that we're playing at the time. So a 2-match series gives us an indication where we are, and we will find out where we are. And then, yes, we move on to the West Indies, but one step at a time.